have not attended it or were not able to submit for any reason, for some other reason, right? So another chance is given to you. If you've already done and submitted, please don't answer. Okay, now coming back to our lesson, what we did. Yeah, Vagisha sir, please switch off your video. Thank you.
Sorry ma'am, I took that screenshot for the purpose of sending to our diet ma'am.
Okay, that you were attending, is it?
Yes ma'am. They asked me to send.
Okay, fine. Yes, last class we discussed the meaning, the objectives of the listening and speaking, developing these two skills. We discussed the meaning of listening, the difference between listening and hearing. Then I hope you all remember this. Importance of listening skill in language. Then the sub-skills. I could see a lot of you mentioning all the answers there in the WhatsApp group. You don't have to put everything in the group because it will all be cluttered there. I just wanted you to do it. It is not for submission. Now you can just mention what all sub-skills you could think of. The words beginning with sub. Anyway, some of you have already mentioned long lists. And I should really appreciate the handwriting of some of yours. Very neat work. Good. But it doesn't mean that everybody has to post it here in the WhatsApp group. That's fine. I hope everybody's seen and you also got to learn quite a few new words also, whatever your friends have been mentioning. Okay? Yes, now these are the sub-skills of listening. Identifying the words in isolated forms, the connective speech, then stress patterns, intonation. And then we also started discussing the activities to develop listening skill. If I remember now, I had given you a small task of making your students listen to you and then draw this particular diagram. One of you has also posted the video itself. And I could see the kind of instructions that you gave. I hope you were able to rectify your instructions. I don't remember the name. You made your child sit there and draw on the whiteboard. That was a very good idea. Please keep trying the different things at home also. So if you're not able to do in the school, because some of you are not able to go to school and it's difficult to meet the children online, they may not be having all these kind of facilities. You can use it, you can implement with your neighbor's children, with your own children, your cousins and anybody there around. So first of all, when you said three dots, then adjacent, and there's so many confusing instructions that you gave to your child. Simple thing would have been this three dots or three small circles, one by the side of the other without touching each other. Okay, in a straight line, draw three small dots, and then below each put a small line and then join the line, and in the middle line extend it further down and then stop. Below that draw a similar circle or a dot. So I don't think the child at that age will understand the meaning of adjacent. They will know beside, next to. Okay, near.
Tell an horizontal.
Okay. Okay. Now we'll just take a quick look at this roadmap. Now, what can we do with this kind of a map? We can give directions. What you can do is you can put this up.
Interrogative sentences, we can frame it, Mira. How far?
How far? Very good. You can ask them directions. How do I go there? How do I reach? Now, when you're using a map and asking them for directions, what are the different prepositions that you can think of? Because language is all integrated, isn't it? If you are talking about listening and speaking, there is something else also getting in. Now we can think of prepositions. Now quickly, instead of talking, maybe you can just type the different... No. Just type it in the chat box. One person, one word, or one or two words, you can just type and don't repeat the answers. You see what your friends have typed? All right. Beside, by, near, nearby. So don't repeat the words which your friends have already mentioned. Otherwise, you'll be wasting time. You write and I'll keep reading them out. All right. Beside, towards, in, on, close to, in, off, at, across, behind, to, in front of, in between. Far, next to, upon. Okay, backwards. Okay, in the middle. Fine. Okay, left side, right side, opposite. You missed out the word opposite. You said in front of, that's fine. Behind, across, under. If you see a bridge, what do you do? Either you go on the bridge or you go under the bridge. Isn't it? Okay, second from left, second right. At the corner, round the corner, across, under. Very good. Okay, dead end. That's nice. So these are important landmarks. At the same time, you're using the prepositions, the direction of words, which will help us use the directions or give directions. Along, there is also along. Now, where will you use the word along when you're giving directions?
Along the road.
Along the road.
Walking along the road.
Yes, when I was walking along the road. Good. Okay, now what we'll do is, I'll just zoom this picture. All right? Now it is very small. I'll just switch off my video camera so that this screen becomes bigger. And I want you to observe the word, the landmarks, important places there in detail. And one person will act as a local light, as if you belong to the city. Another person is asking you some directions. Okay, so I would like to have two people, one asking for directions and the other one giving directions. Observe the picture carefully. And when I ask you, you will start. Any two persons who are going to unmute later will get a chance. So don't do it right now. First, observe. No, Bharti, please unmute now. Yes.